Hello friends, welcome to Spartan CRE. This is our second video from Geometry Nova playlist. So in our first video, I have made a video explanation for easy level questions. Okay, so we are done questions. Now we will move on to medium level questions. All right, so let's get started. Our first question says, column A, column B. Only in a triangle, only angle B is given, A, B, C. Only this is given 72 degrees, right? Now they are comparing between A and 72, B. Suppose if I take A is equal to B, so I will take A as 72, then will it meet the triangle requirements? That means total sum should be 180 degrees. So here it is 144. So C obviously can be greater than 1. So 144 means C will be 636 degrees. So this is fine. So A equal to B is correct. Now I will take value greater than B. Suppose if I take A as 73 degrees, then C will be 35 degrees. Even then triangle will be formed. So A greater than B is also valid. Now I will take A less than B. So instead of 73, I will take 71 here. So total sum will be 143 and C will be 37 degrees. So this is also a requirement, meets triangle property. So this is also correct. Since all the three are satisfied, your answer will be D. That means cannot be determined. We cannot exactly determine which is the correct answer. Right. Let's move on to our 14th question. Here the figure is like this. So friends, before watching this video, try pause the video, solve the question on your own. Then compare the method which I am telling and your method. So you have to learn the quicker ways of solving the questions. Okay, in the figure AD, these are intersecting lines. What is the value of A? This is the question. What is the value of A? Normally, how people will solve these questions is, see this and this are vertically opposite angles. So 5x plus 5a will be equal to 5y by 2. This is one equation. And you have second equation, that is y is equal to 2x plus 30. This is second equation. These two equations are not sufficient to solve this question. Why? Because we have one variable here, two variables, three variables. But then we have only two equations, right? So we need one more equation to solve this question. So you will take third equation using this property. Y plus 5y by 2 will be equal to 180. This will be your third equation. Using this, you will get the value of y. You will put the value of y here. You will get to x. Then once you get x and y, you will put these values in equation 1. Then finally, you will get answer A. So this is the normal traditional method. Even this method, you can see in book, they follow the same method. But then I will tell you a much better way. See this. I'm just taking these two equations. I can even solve using taking two equations. How? I have three variables and two equations. So I need at least two variables to solve the question. So third variable, I can make it zero. So what I will do is, in this question, right? So what I will do is, I want A, right? So I will make X as zero. I will make this as zero. So what will be this equation then? It will be 5a will be equal to 5y by 2. This equation 1, right? Since I made x as 0, right? So I'll solve in much better way. See this, what I'll do is, since here, if you see these two equations, I have these two things, right? I'll make x as 0. So this will be 5a and this will be 30. That's it. So 5a plus 30, you know this value will be 180 because this is a straight line. Now 5a will be 150, right? A will be 30 degrees. See, I will solve this in a much easier way. What I'm telling you is, suppose we have three variables and two equations. In that case, what you can do is, you can make one variable as zero. You understand this? For suppose if you have four variables and you have only two equations with you, then you can make two variables as zero and solve the question. Now here, see this, we got two equations, right? Two equations are there and we have three variables. X is one variable, A is one variable, Y is one variable. Two equations and three variables. So what you can do is, you can make one variable equal to zero. So now you can choose whichever variable you want to make it zero. But so what are the two equations here? 5x plus 5a equal to 5y by 2. This is my equation 1. Equation 2 will be y is equal to 2x plus 30. This is my equation 2. Right? So I'll make one variable 0. I cannot make a 0, but because why we can't make a 0 is we need a value. Right? So I'll make x as 0. So if I make x as 0, this equation will get converted into 5a is equal to 5y by 2. So a will be equal to y by 2. We are done with this. Now put x is equal to 0 in second equation also, then it will become y is equal to 30. Now put this value in this equation, you'll get a equal to 30 by 2, which is 15 degrees. So your answer will be 15 degrees. That's it. So this is the easiest way to solve the question. Otherwise, even in book, the solution is very difficult. First of all, they write the three equations, they solve the three equations, then they get the answer, which at least it will take 2 minutes of your time. But then with this logic, my logic, what is this? Four equations, four variables and two equations, you can make two variables as zero. With that logic, you can solve this question very easily in less than 10 seconds, right? Okay. And one more thing, here you see, here this is one variable, this is one variable. You can't make here x as zero. Why? Because this is not an equation. We get equation only when we equalize some variables to some constant or some variable, anything here. Here you see 5x plus 5a equal to 5y by 2. This is called equation, because if you take this 5y by 2 this side, you will be equating it to 0. So something should be equated to 0 to call it as an equation. So here this is not an equation. Equations are these two are equations. These three are called as equations. Right? So let's move on to our next question. From the figure, which of the following must be true? Right. See here, they compare, first look at the options, they're comparing between y and z. What is y here? Y will be equal to 3x. What is z here? Z will be equal to x. It is very much clear that y is greater than z. Why? Because this x cannot be negative. Never angle is a negative, okay? Always it will be positive. So y will be greater than z. So option D is correct. Now, 16th question. What could be the value of B? See here, the angle around a point is always 360 degrees. If you add all these things, let us add all these things. So we'll get one equation. A, 2A, 5A. 5A and this A by 2 will get cancelled. So 5A we got. Next to B will get cancelled. This B, 2B get cancelled. So 5A equal to 360 degrees. So A will be 72 degrees. This is what we got. Now they are asking what could be the possible value of B. Right. So how can we find this? To find this, I can take this one. And here you see 2A minus B should always be greater than 0, because I told you angles can never be negative. So this is obviously greater than 0. So 2A is greater than B. Okay. So B is less than 2A. This one equation. Put it aside. Right. Next. This one also I can take. 2 into A minus B is greater than 0. So A minus B is greater than 0. So A is greater than B. This is your second equation. Now, any other equations possible? I can take this one also. B minus A by 2 is greater than 0. So B is greater than A by 2. B is greater than A by 2. So we got A value. This is equation 3. We got A value. So B will be, B is greater than 36 degrees, this is fine. And we have to find less than value also, because the range, to find a range we always need one greater than and one less than. Here we got greater than value, B is greater than 36 degrees, this is fine. Now find something where B is less than. So we already got one equation here, B is less than 2A, that means 72 degrees. So we got both the things. For single variable we got greater than and less than values, so we can find the range. So B is greater than 36, means 36 is the minimum value, 36 is less than B is less than 72 degrees. So this is the range of B. Now search in the options, it should be greater than 36, less than 72. So C will be your answer, right? Now 17th question, AD is the longest side of a right triangle ABD. And I want to tell you something here, right triangle ABD means, normally if I say right triangle ABC, that means by default angle B will be 90 degrees, right? But then the question here, we cannot take it for granted all the time in our GRE questions. Why? Because here they said AD is the longest side of right triangle ABD. Don't straight away conclude that angle B is 90 degrees. You should conclude it based on some clue. Here the clue is AD is the longest side of the triangle ABD. Since this is the longest side, you know in a right angle triangle, the longest side will be opposite to hypotenuse. So AD is your hypotenuse. That means ABD angle B will be 90 degrees. So he is asking what is the length of longest side of ABC. If you take this triangle, you retry it this way. A, B, C, these 4, these 5, so this will be root of 16 plus 25, which is root 41. So this will be your answer. Why? Because if I take this as A, this as B, in a right angle triangle, hypotenuse will be C will be equal to root of A square plus B square. Let us solve our next question. Question number 18, find the value of A. So here, first of all, identify some things like B is equal to 3C. This is equation 1 because they are vertically opposite angles. Similarly, A will be 2B. A will be 2B. This is equation 2. Now you want A, right? So take these three things. Then 6C plus A plus B will be equal to 180 degrees. Now you have to solve for A, right? Your A is equal to, you take 2B, A equal to 2B. So this will be 6C plus 3B equal to 180 degrees. Now C plus 2C plus B will be equal to 3 will be 60 degrees. Okay, 2C plus B will be equal to 60 degrees. Here you use this equation here, B is 3C, right? So 5C will be 60 degrees, C will be 12 degrees. C will be 12 degrees, put the value here, it will be 36 degrees. Put the value here, you will get A is equal to 72 degrees. This is your final answer. Here, have you noticed one thing? Here we are unable to make one equation zero. Why? Because here we don't have anything like plus something or minus something, because therefore if we make something as zero, this will make B as zero, and in turn this B will make A as zero, so everything will become zero. So that's why you cannot use that zero logic here, right? Now let's move on to our next question. In the figure, line L and M are parallel, which of the following is true? That makes line P and Q as well also parallel. See here, in the book the solution was made very complex, okay? I am telling you a direct way. Actually I have explained this method in our geometry concepts lecture 1, where I explained parallel lines video. So to make this P and Q, which one should be right? What you will do is, anyway these two are parallel lines given. Now he is saying P and Q are also parallel, right? Now see here, see the directional things. We have double arrow, single arrow like this. So here also we have double arrow, single arrow. So here it will be B degrees. Agree? Here it will be B degrees. Now, if this line and this line are parallel, what is this? B will be equal to C, alternate angles. So B degrees will be equal to C. So this should be your condition. So B is equal to C. That is your answer. That's it. Now, 20th question. A, B, C, D are points on a line such that B bisects AC and A point A bisects CD. First of all, go by backtracking like this here. A bisects CD. Suppose I have C and D. A bisects CD. So this is 1 and this is 1. Now, point B bisects AC. Point B bisects AC means point B will be somewhere here. Somewhere here. Suppose if this is 1 and this is 1, this value will become 2. Why? Because A bisects CD, right? And B bisects AD. So that means here 1 and 1. That means here it will be 2. It is asking what is the ratio of AB is to CD. What is AB here? Value is 1. 1 by what is the total value? 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 2, 4. It will be 1 by 4. That's it. Let's move on to our next question. 21st question. A, B, C, D, E are points on a plane such that CD bisects ACB. So let's draw first angle ACB. This is A, C, B. Now CD bisects angle ACB. So this is CD and this is alpha. This will be alpha. Now the line CB bisects right angle ACE. So ACE will be your right angle. This is your right angle. This complete thing. Now we are saying CB, this line CB bisects right triangle. So it is bisecting this angle means if this is 2 alpha, this angle alone will be 2 alpha. Now you can observe one thing. This complete total angle is 90 degrees here. Complete total angle. So complete total angle is 4 alpha, which is equal to 90 degrees. Alpha will be 25 degrees. So not 25 degrees. Alpha will be 90 by 4 degrees. He is asking what is DCE, angle DCE, that means this angle. So he is asking 3 alpha value. 3 alpha value will be 90 by 4 into 3. This you should calculate. It will be 270 by 4, which gives you 6 are 24, and anyway it will become, because 4 6 are 24, 3 30 you will get, 7 are 28. So this will be your answer, 67.5 degrees. Let's move on to our next question. From the figure, which of the following must be true? This is your figure and you see here, this will be external angle for this triangle. Let us mark this A, B, C. So X will be your external angle. So X will be 35 plus Y degrees. So now check here, X plus Y is equal to 90 degrees. That we cannot guarantee X plus Y, but what we can say is X minus Y will be 35 degrees. This is true, but you can't say X plus Y is 90 degrees, right? No way we can determine that value here. So this is wrong. X is 35 units greater than Y. This is correct. X is 35 units greater than Y. So this is correct. X is 35 units less than Y. X is 35 units less than Y is wrong. So only option B is correct. Now let's solve our next question. 23rd. In the figure, triangle ABC and ABD are right triangles. We said triangle ABC and ABD are right triangles. That doesn't mean that B is compulsorily 90 degrees. I told you triangle ABC is right angle means we cannot say that triangle is right angle at angle B. But if I say angle ABC is right angle, then it means that triangle is right angle at angle B. Right? So here, right angle can be here, either here or either here. We said triangle ABC is and ABD, both are right triangles. Suppose if I take my right angle as this one, I'm taking this is as right angle. So what will be my this angle? This angle will be 70 degrees. Till now, fine. Now, if I take X as 90 degrees, in big triangle, if I take this as 90 degrees, so in my big triangle, this is 20 degrees, fine. This cannot be 90 degrees. This angle cannot be 90 degrees. Why? Because this small part itself is 90 degrees, right? So this will definitely be greater than 90 degrees. So this angle, this complete angle will definitely be greater than 90 degrees. This is fine. Now, if this is 90 degrees, then total angle is 110 degrees and this angle should be 70 degrees. So here we are getting a conflict. You see here, this angle should be greater than 90 degrees, but then we are getting only 70 degrees. This total angle you are getting 70 degrees. That means here this angle B is not equal to ABC is not equal to 90 degrees. So our assumption is wrong. Now we will take, we'll consider some other way. Now see, triangle ABC is right angle, so this is failed here. Now C will be 90 degrees. This is 90 degrees means this will be 70 degrees. Now again triangle ABD is 90 degrees. So this is 20 degrees. If this is 90 degrees, if this is 90 degrees, this will become 20 degrees. So 90, 20, so this will be 70. This is fine. So this can be 70 degrees. Can I take in some other way? Suppose this is 20, this is 90, and can this angle be 90 degrees? If I take this angle as 90 degrees, this total angle will be 70 degrees. But then this small part itself we got 70 degrees. So even x is 90 degrees is wrong. Anyway, that is proved in our earlier assumption. So your answer will be 70 degrees. Now, our next question. In the figure, ABC is a right triangle. Again, don't confuse that. Don't think that angle B is 90 degrees. Okay. But here, he said ABC is a right triangle. What is the value of y? He said ABC is a right angle. So this can be right angle or this can be a right angle. Suppose if I take this as right angle, I will take this as right angle. So this angle will be, y will be 70 degrees, correct? If y is 70 degrees, so y is 70 degrees, he said this is also 70 degrees. If this is 70 degrees, this will total will be 90. So this angle will be 90 degrees. But then total y is 70 degrees here. That's why our assumption is again wrong. Y is 70 degrees, y is, this x 790 degrees is wrong here. X is 90 degrees is wrong. So we cannot take that way. Now let us try in another way. I will take, now my right angle, I will take y as 90 degrees. If I take this as 90 degrees, this will be 70 degrees. And this is 90 degrees again. So this total 110, so this angle should be 70 degrees. This is fine again. This total is 90 degrees means this small angle is 70 degrees and this will be 20 degrees, which is fine again. This is again right angle here. So totally it is sufficient, satisfied. So your answer, x is 90 degrees is wrong here. So y will be 90 degrees. So taking y as 90 degrees is correct. Now, 25th question, which of the following are the measures of the sides of five different triangles? Which one represents the right triangle? Simple, right triangle is nothing but, if I take this as right triangle ABC, then C square should be equal to A square plus B square. That means square of larger side should be equal to sum of the squares of smaller sides. Here, this is a larger side, larger one. So square it, it will be 5, should be equal to this square plus this square. The root 3 square will be 3 and root 4 square will be 4. This is not equal to this, so this is wrong. Again, this is a bigger side, so 25 should be equal to 1 square plus 4 square. Again, this is not equal, so this is wrong. Take this, 7 square 49 should be equal to 3 square plus 4 square. This is again not equal because 25 is not equal to 49, so this is wrong. Take this, 7 root 7 is equal to 7, root 3 square is 3, root 4 square is 4, this is equal, so option D will be your right answer. Next, 26, and this will be your last question for this video. ABC is a right angle isosceles triangle and the angle B is a right angle. So is it, this is the angle B is right angle, ABC is your right isosceles right angle triangle. This is A means this will be A. Now, if AC measures 7 root 2, which of the following would be the length of B, AB and AC? So he is asking the value of A. He Here, instead of blindly applying hypotenuse rule, that means a square plus a square is equal to 7 root 2 whole square, don't solve this way. Okay, I'll tell one rules for I'll tell some three sets of fixed triangles. See here, if I have a triangle with 30, 60, 90 degrees, okay, 30 degrees, 60 degrees, 90 degrees, then the sides ratio will be 1 is to root 3 is to 2. Similarly, if I have a triangle with 45 degrees, 45 degrees, 90 degrees, then sides ratio will be 1 is to 1 is to root 2. Okay. If I have a triangle with 60 is to 60 degrees is 60, then sides ratio will be 1 is to 1 is to 1. So here the triangle is isosceles right angle triangle. That means this angle will be 45, this angle will be 45 degrees. So your triangle is 45, 45, 90 degrees triangle. So sides ratio will be 1 is to 1 is to root 2. This root 2 value is given as 7 root 2 because side opposite to 90 degrees should be in root 2 ratio. So root 2 value they have given 7 root 2. So one value will be 7. So this A and A, these values should be equal to 1. So one value equal to 7. So your answer will be option A. So in our next video, we will solve from problem number 27. Hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you.